Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all my students and my viewers. I know this is a very different atmosphere that you are seeing right now in front of you. I thought if the channel's name is Unconventional Learning, why not we should try a different surrounding, because as we are not in the classroom, that also means that we don't need to be specially limited to a room when we are studying. So I have brought you all to my terrace, and here there's a little bit of greenery, there's fresh air, there's open sky, and I hope you all will enjoy today's video. And let's begin without wasting any further time. So today's first word is diplomatic. It is diplomatic. D-I-P-L-O-M-A-T-I-C. Now, diplomatic means having a quality of dealing with things in a tactful way, doing negotiations but in a tactful way. Tactful here means, tact means sambhalna, the way you handle things, that is known as the way you tackle things. So tactful manner, manner means you are doing in a very smooth manner. You tum koi bhi cheez ko sambhal rahe ho bilkul ek aasan tarike se, that is tactful. So generally this word is used when we are having international relations between different countries, among different countries. All right, it comes from a Latin word, diploma. Diploma, we all know, it's an official document, and in the late 18th century it was given to a journal document which dealt with international affairs. So again, I told you this word means doing negotiations, as in tum sambhal rahe ho situation ko bilkul ek bahut smooth manner mein, bilkul clever manner mein, bina apna nuksan kiye aur bina dusre ko nuksan diye. You're doing in that manner. That is diplomatic. Generally, this word is associated with double-minded. But no, it's not that. Diplomatic is a quality, a good quality. If you are that, you are able to handle a lot of relations, especially professional, in a very smooth manner. All right. So let us take the sentences. One need to be diplomatic when they are handling difficult foreign situations. Because if you are, for example, we are having India and China, the difficulty and the tense situation is there. So one needs to be diplomatic in order to calm down the situation. All right. I'm not saying that is the only solution, but it can be one of the solutions. Diplomatic, again, handling situations in a very tactful manner, in a very clever manner. All right. Second example we can take. His diplomatic behavior helped him to escape the difficult situation, or helped him to escape the very weird situation, because he was unable to get out of the situation, but because he had this ability to handle the situation properly, so he came out of the situation very well. Alright? Okay, the second word for today is despondent. Despondent. D-E-S-P-O-N-D-E-N-T. Now, this word means having no courage, no hope, being filled with sorrow, a state of loneliness where you are, you have given all the hopes that you could, and you are in a very low situation, that is known as despondent. Now, it comes from the Latin word despondere. Alright, this means to lose courage or to give up. And then it is further divided into D-E, that is from, and spondere is to promise. So if you promise someone something, you are promising to give the person happiness, to give the person all that he wants, which generally links to happiness again. But here we have despondent. So despondere. Alright, so this means no promise of hope, no promise of love, no promise of life. So that is complete loss of hope, complete sorrow. This is known as despondent. Alright, so let us take us examples. Seeing his low grades, he became despondent towards his career and future. Obviously, when one sees their low grades in their exam, the exam paper, the result which comes out, that everybody, no matter the student is very joyful or the student is very hopeless in his life, no matter how much good or how much bad you are in your daily life, once you see the low grades, you become kind of unhappy, you kind of lose hope. So that is despondent. All right. Next example, we all can relate to that, this lockdown has left all of us, or this lockdown has left most of us despondent. Why despondent? Because obviously people are losing hope, people are having no desire to live life, and they have become very hopeless in today's world. All right, so despondent. Okay, so third word for today is disheveled. Disheveled. D-I-S-H-E-V-E-L-L-E-D. Disheveled. Now this word means untidy. Generally it relates to a person or his or her appearance, and it means untidy or messy, not properly clean. You are not properly dressed up. You are disheveled, means you are untidy, your hair is messy, you're not wearing proper clothes. That is disheveled. Generally it's related to a person's appearance. If you see a person who has just the person has woken up from his or her sleep, his or her hair is disheveled. One of the examples. All right. So it comes from a Latin word capillus, and then it translates into chevel, of an old French word chevel, which means hair. So again, disheveled. So if you put dis or d in front of any word, you are taking away that quality of that particular word. So if chevel means hair, disheveled means you know, not your hair is not properly presented in your body. For example, right now I'm not disheveled because my hair is properly in its place. If wind blows and all my hair gets tangled, then I'll be having a disheveled appearance. All right. Okay, so example, we can take one more. One we have already said about the person who has woken up from his or her sleep. Second example we can take, after a long football match, he appeared completely disheveled. Because obviously he was looking untidy, he was looking all messy after a long tiring football match. So the fourth word for today is discerning. It is discerning. D-I-S-C-E-R-N-I-N-G. Now this word, we have already done a word which is almost similar to this word. Let us see if you remember or not. So this word means showing good judgment, having or showing good judgment regarding a person's style or quality. You're showing good judgment. All right. Birds are there. So I thought I saw something moving. I needed to see what it was. So obviously this is the one of the perks of teaching in an open under the sky, because you find a lot of things which are unusual. All right. So discerning, having or showing good judgment. Now this word comes from discernia. So D again here means apart, and cernia means separate. So you are separating, you are trying to understand, you're trying to discern, means you're trying to just separate a lot of things, and you're trying to understand what the person's quality is all about, or what the person's style is all about. And then the root meaning transfers to discernier. Discernier. We also had a word whose root meaning was discernier, which was discreet, having a showing a careful analysis, a wise analysis about a particular thing. That was discreet. D-I-S-C-R-E-E-T. Now discerning, again having a showing good judgment. For example, if I say she has a good discerning ability, which means she understands and she analyzes how people work, how people are, and she can understand who is lying, who is not lying, through their behavior, through their style, through the way they talk and everything. All right. So the sentences we can take, many students have difficulty in discerning which lines are important in a particular chapter. Obviously, you are not able to discern, you are not able to judge which lines are important. Therefore, the teacher of that particular subject makes you all mark those lines. Or second example we can take, having a discerning quality helps people to make less mistakes. Obviously, if you have that ability, if you have that quality of properly judging people, not judging because you are having fun in it, but judging, not exactly telling someone that tum aise ho, tum waise ho, tum itne gande ho, not that judgment. You are analyzing. Analyzing as in you are tum barik barik karke us insaan ko samajh rahe ho. You are understanding what the person is all about. And then you are making a judgment. You are making a conclusion out of it. वो जिस इंसान के अंदर वो एबिलिटी होता है दैट पर्सन जनरली टेंड्स टू मेक लेस मिस्टेक्स ऑब्वियसली बिकॉज वो जानेगा किस पर्सन को ट्रस्ट करना है किस पर्सन को ट्रस्ट नहीं करना है. लास्ट वर्ड फॉर द डे इज डोसाइल DOCILE docile. Now this word means being submissive towards another person or having this quality of getting under control very easily. If a person tries to dominate you, you are easily under the control and you're being submissive, you're submitting yourself. You are for example, you submit your notebooks to the teacher, you are giving the notebook to the teacher to check. So if you submit yourself, you're being submissive, which means you are letting the person in front of you, you're allowing the person in front of you do whatever he or she wants to do with you, to treat you however he or she wants, and you are okay with it. That is docile. Alright, it comes from the word docere in Latin, docere, which means to teach. So if you are docile, you are allowing everybody else to teach you, everybody else to tell you what to do, and you are listening to the person. That is docile. So the examples we can take: the huge dog was unexpectedly docile and friendly. Obviously, if you see a huge dog, a big dog, you have this feeling that the dog can be ferocious. Ferocious means janleva ho sakta hai, tumko aake darauna ho sakta hai, tumko attack kar sakta hai. But unexpectedly, he was docile, he was submissive, he was readily accepting anybody's control, and he was friendly. Theek hai? Second example we can take: the crowd is generally docile in nature. They readily believe anybody's words, or they readily believed the politician's speech, because the crowd, tum is taraf mudoge wo is taraf mudega, tum is taraf mudoge wo is taraf mudega. The crowd is the most uncertain bunch of people who can never be trusted, any crowd for that matter, because when a crowd comes, that crowd does not have individual minds. They don't have the ability to discern, they don't have good judgment, they are docile, they just digest, they just take in whatever people tell them. Alright, so docile, okay. So the five words for today are diplomatic, dogmatic, despondent, disheveled, and docile. So these are the five words for today. I hope you all enjoyed a different kind of atmosphere which I have tried to put in, because generally what happens, we study in this claustrophobic atmosphere and our minds get shut. So I also thought that why not give it a try. So I will meet again in the next week. But then, yes, before that, let me just tell you all an important notice. I am thinking of discontinuing this 5x5 classes, because you all know that from July onwards, our regular lecture will begin, that is related to our syllabus, that is Flamingo chapters. So I need you all to tell me that what should, whether if I am thinking of discontinuing 5x5 classes, is it okay, or do you want me to continue it? The comment section is open. Please let your views come there. I need to know that my viewers, all the subscribers, all the viewers who are watching, whether they want me to continue 5x5 or not, because I was having certain health issues and there's a bit now left, but still, if you all want it, I will definitely go ahead with it, but it all depends on what is your response. So please let me know in the comment section whether you want or you don't want the 5x5 classes to continue from next week onwards. If you want, then we'll begin with letter E, and if not, then we'll see what to do. All right, so stay happy, stay home, stay safe, and please enjoy watching the lectures. I hope I am trying to do justice with whatever initiative that has been taken. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you all.